I'm Donna Moore, and this is an Axel Masterclass. So at the start, I like to be able to power clean as many reps as I possibly can. Now, power cleaning or Olympic lifting kind of, although it's not as beautiful as Olympic lifting, has so much crossover into strongman. And if you're not practicing any kind of Olympic lifts in your programming, you're really missing out on a big bang for your buck. The extension or the jump and catch has a lot of crossover into log, sandbag throwing, Atlas stones, tire flip, anything where there is a hip extension involved. So once we've done a few sets of the power clean and press, you're feeling warm and comfortable with the movement, that the movement is efficient and snappy across all of the cleaning, the catch and the press, then I would add some more weight, and for me, I'm probably gonna add another 20 kilos and then do maybe another set of 3 reps at that weight, have a bit more of a rest. So the main things that are a problem with axle clean is the grip being, we said, like the limiting factor. So I would still work up to a comfortable weight without struggling too much. So here we are back with the axle, and this time I'm going to show you how to mix grip with a belt clean. The way I like to see it is we are actually aiming for over the belt. The belt is not like the place that we want it. We are going to aim as high as possible. I prefer to do this as a mixed grip. Other people like to do this as an overhand. But again, with grip being the limiting factor, you are probably more able to, on a fat axle bar, able to clean more with a mixed grip as if you were going to be deadlifting. So I find this technique works best for me. It may not work best for everybody, but I think if you can practice it, especially using a lot of leg drive, practicing some of the Olympic lifts as best that you can, then you really get like a lot of bang for your buck out of your legs. So if you're doing a max axle competition, obviously leg drive is important. And if you're doing a reps competition, leg drive is important. But also it's nailing the technique every single time so that you save time and efficiency and tiredness so that you would win the rep event. So another part of obviously axle clean and press is the press part of it. It's great that you can clean up your body, but you also need to be able to press that. Also, pressing out of the rack, push press, push jerk or split jerk, whichever you prefer to do, is a great way to be able to stabilize the weight, but without having to clean it from the floor, which is obviously more tiring. So I do also do quite a lot of just pressing out of the rack to be able to build up to lifting heavier weights. So recently I've been working a bit more on shoulder mobility, lat flexibility. So whereas before I probably would have held the bar somewhere up here, now I'm able to keep the bar lower down and lift up my elbows. So I found that as great big benefit for it. Again, like we talked about, incorporating some of the Olympic lifts into your training has definitely been a big benefit to me and made me a better athlete at these kind of events. Also having a healthier body rather than being so stiff that you can't actually rest your arms down on your body. You must add other variations of pressing into your program. So there is a strict press, push press, banded presses, tricep work, making sure that lockout is going to be strong. I'm a big advocate of overhead marches. If you've seen my Instagram, I do that quite a lot with unstable loads, so that when the load's above your head with a straight bar, you are going to be more securely locked in place because you've been practicing with an unstable load. So working the smaller muscle groups definitely helps to be able to lift bigger weights. Thank you for coming to my Axel Masterclass. If you've got any other questions, pop them in the comments below.